Alright, so welcome to ITE 351 Student Activity Sheet Module 6 kita. So, let's try to finish this one before mag-end aton nga first period. Alright, so lesson title, Choosing a Form of Business. Lesson objectives, by the end of the module, the student is expected to be or to able to 1. Enumerate and explain the different forms of business. Compare the different forms of business. Number 3. Know what forms of business they should apply. Materials, our student activity sheet. Then for the reference, so you can check this in the internet. So ang aton nga basis or the reference of our module. Alright, so for the productivity tip, a lot of businesses do not consider the form of their business at the start. Knowing this ahead actually gives your business an edge on how it will be performing. Wait lang. Medyo may noise. Kasi na na. Okay, ano? Wait lang. See, let's proceed. So, welcome back, future venture capitalist. Today, we'll be discussing the different forms of businesses. Perhaps, you have heard of three of them. Sole proprietorship, partnership, and corporation. So, anyone can briefly explain those forms of businesses. Proprietorship, partnership, and corporation. Alex, have you ever or did you remember these three forms of businesses?
Ay, module 2. Module 2 na sa sir, no?
Ha? Module 2 na siya? So, let's check.
Dugin discuss module 2.
Let's check this one. Di na to. Sorry siya. Makita mo. Alex, can you please read?
Yes, sir. The concept of the project is making a business plan. Thus, it requires the students to determine if they will be a sole proprietor, one owner but can have many companions, partnership, 2-4 owners split equally or depending on agreement, or corporation, 2-4 owners using percentage as voting power for decisions.
Okay, so PINMA UI is a type of what? Proprietorship, partnership, or corporation? PINMA Education.
Corporation.
Corporation. Corporation. So, how about when the two or ANC and ABS-CBN? ANC and ABS-CBN? Did you hear that? ABS-CBN or ano na lang para well known sa inyo. PLDT and the SMART. PLDT and SMART.
Partnership. Sila nga
primarily, PLDT is well known as landline company or telecommunication company. So ang services niya is it's all about telephone, no? Kung paano sila magatag services through their landline services. So san-san o lang siya nagka-internet?
Sa nagabot si Smart.
Diba? So nag-open na sila doon sa ano. So that's why partnership sila. So for the proprietorship or proprietor, when you build your business, for example, ang mga kiosk, no? For example, may ara ka sang ano? May ara kaya sang online selling. Okay? With DTI, business permit, may ara kaya. So, kung may ara kaya ang original or gina-build, gina-manage niya business, ikaw lang yang isa, yung, ikaw lang yang tagiya, and then may mga upod ka ang agabulig sa imo. So what do you call that one? So that is
Chair. Oh. Pamangkot ko, sir. Ang Jollibee kag McDo, sir, sole proprietor na sila, sir.
Hindi, corporation na sila. Cause hindi lang isang nag-decide ra. Hindi lang isang ga-decide damo nga mga ano da owners. Oh. Damo dang owners. So hindi siya pwede mambal nga sole because even McDo and Jollibee has a partnership sa iban nga mga ano may mga sa iban nga mga companies, no? And for example sa mga franchises, di ba? So ano siya? So that's as find the no reference. Wait lang. So, ari ang aton nga reference. Can you see? Anyone can see?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Jollibee is a Filipino multinational chain of fast food restaurant owned by Jollibee Food Corpo. Oh, corporation siya. So, hindi lang siya ano, hindi lang siya isa ang tag-iya. And then, every time there is a decision to made, may ara sang voting power ang aton nga board members. So may mga board members dira where it has the privilege to vote kung ano ang magiging decision sang, for example, di ba subong may mga restrictions kita, paano nila i-manage ang ilang business in spite of the community restriction or quarantine status naton sa kada syudad. So every time may ara sila sang, for example, 24 hours naton na or i-close naton ang amon nga business sa amon nga syudad. So there is a what we call decision making in the board members. So may mga voting power din sila. So hindi lang siya isa lang kabilog ang tag-iya. Okay? So and then even may mga partnership na siya. So if we go deeper in the details of the Jollibee. Alright, so let's proceed. Thank you so much for the collaboration, Mr. Ludico. Alright, so tinata. So that's sole proprietorship, partnership, and corporation. Today we will be adding another one. May isa pa gidyali to this, which is LLC or Limited Liability Company. We will compare each of them, especially their advantages. and disadvantages. So for the activity one, what I know chart, write in the first column of what you know with regards to the questions from the second column, Arisha. The third column is left blank at this time. So please answer, what is sole proprietorship, partnership, corporation, and LLC? So na-discuss na yung last time, diba? So medyo masigdasig lang siguro nga muna yung module, because we have already discussed this one. Okay, in module number 1, I think, no? 1. So, choosing a form of business presently in the Philippines. Anyway, are you still there? Jerick, ano pa? Ay, pa-accept ko si Jerick. Ilang yun? Automatic na siya mo? Automatic admit?
Ah, nasa sir?
Ah, nasa? Oo.
Oh. Oo. Oh.
Sige, sige, mayo lang. So, let's proceed now. Presently, in the Philippines, there are 4 forms of business, 3 of which are mostly used, but the 4th one is soon to be more common. We have sole proprietorship, partnership, corporation, and finally, limited liability company or LLC. We will discuss each of them. So, again, so to briefly explain our forms of businesses in the Philippines. So the simplest form of business entity is the sole proprietorship. A sole proprietorship is a form of business organization involving one person, and the person in the business are essentially the same. Sole proprietorship are the most prevalent form of business organization. The two most important advantages of sole proprietorship are that the owner maintains complete control over the business. So, may ara, agad siya sa control, no? Kumbaga, kung mag-build ka isang isa ka business, dapat nag-hands-on ka, kid. Kaya kung hindi ka mag-hands-on, lalo na kung startup business na, umpisa pa lang ang pag-build mo, newbie ka pa lang, dira. And then, kung hindi ka mag-hands-on, hindi mo gid mabantayan ang imong insights or business insights. So kung sa diin gataas nubo ang imong income, kung sa no ang demand kag ang sa diin ano nga mga bulan lugi ka. Okay, may mga natawag kita nga mga season kung sa diin bakal ang mga amo na nga mga items. Okay, for example, in December, ano ang mga bakal dira nga mga items? Sample, tag-ulan, anong mga items ang bakal? Kung tag-init, anong mga items ang bakal or product? Diba? So, those are the considerations nga gina-manage, okay? Gina-control sa owner. So, that's why in sole proprietorship, the owner maintains complete control over the business, and that business losses can be deducted against the owner's personal tax return. Setting up a sole proprietorship, okay, is cheap and relatively easy compared to the other forms of business. Wait lang. Okay. Wait lang, kami nag-notify sa akin. Compared to the other forms of business ownership, the only legal requirement in most states is to obtain the appropriate license and permits to do business. So for legal and ethical practice, you need to process the business permit. Okay, so that's why every time yung mag-addo ka mo sa mga businesses or mga what do you call that one, mga spaces, okay, mga buildings, may mga naka-attach nga mga license to operate, okay, permits, and even sa mga jeepney, sa mga jeep la, mga operators. So may mga naka-attach dira sa mga gilid-gilid, kung sa diyan dira nila gina-attach ang permits to operate, no? So that is very important to have a permit para nga ano, para legal ang pagano, ang pag hatag sang serbisyo sa aton nga susyudad. Okay, so for the advantages of the sole proprietorship, creating one is easy and inexpensive. The owner maintains complete control of the business and retains all the profits. Business losses can be deducted against the sole proprietor, other resource or sources of income. It is not subject to double taxation, explained later. Okay, explain siya later. Ang ginatawag na double taxation. So, the business is easy to dissolve. So, these are the advantages of the sole proprietorship. So, for the advantages of sole proprietorship, the liability on the owner's part is unlimited. So, medyo masakit-sakit, no? Liability on the owner's part. Every time habis kan gani sa partnership or sa corporation, the owner has the direct liability, no? For example, dumduman yung kaya, no? Ang kaya sa ABS-CBN, diba? So direct man ang attack siya sang House of Representative sang ginkandak ang renewal sang franchise sang ABS-CBN. So sino ganyang ang owner sang ABS-CBN. Si Lopez. Lopez Group of Companies, Lopez Inc. Incorporated. So direct man ang pag-attack siya. So basically the disadvantage in sole proprietorship, liability on the owner's part is unlimited. So, ikaw gini bahala, unless otherwise you manage your companions, okay, to operate your business. So the business relies on the skills and abilities of a single owner. Wow. So dapat skilled and maabilidad to be successful. Of course, the owners can hire employees who have additional skills and abilities. Okay? So for example, if you want to build a business, ikaw Lebrico, ang mo itong ginaba ko last time. Nga, for example, if you want to build a YouTube channel, okay? Diba si Letiron, kyan lang na sa mga YouTube channels, what you call, permits to operate, no? Pero I don't think so, because that is World Wide Web mo. Okay, hindi na siya limited lang in the Philippines. Okay, and then ang aton nga country is a democratic country. So, it's hard to control the World Wide Web. Even though nga ginasulod na sang mga legislators, okay, in Congress and in Senate, na magka-tax na ang mga may-ara sang YouTube channel and under sa Facebook, no. So let's see, no. So we don't know kung ano matabo. So again, of course, the owner can hire employees who have additional skills and abilities. So dire, it is very important, okay, nga dapat kabalo ka magamit sang skills sang iban. If you are the owner and you have the capital to operate, to start a business, then may mga kilala ka dira nga kabalo, no? Kabalo sa sample, kabalo mag-welding, no? Kabalo mag-welding. So, mapatindog ka karoon ng shop. Okay, mapatindog ka sa shop and then mang-hire ka sa mga kabalo nga mag-welding. So, karoon, depende na kung ano na siyang inyong istoryahan, dira. Commission base or daily rate. Okay? Ang yatag mo sa imo nga skilled worker. Ang capital mo lang is your space, ang area, ang location, ang expenses like tubig or electricity, Then ang iyong mga ano, application to application para makakuha some permits or license. Ano pa gid? So and mga ano, mga gadgets. Okay nga kailan or devices. So kung may ara kasi na ang mga resources and may mga kilala ka nya mga skilled worker, so pwede mo na maumpisa ng iyong mga business. Okay, lalo na subong kita nyo na ang ano, ang tuktok rider. So ang pag-idea ko, may mga thousands lang na i-prepare mo. Okay, thousands lang na i-prepare mo para makakuha ka sa ano, sa franchise na. So if you have a what we call starting capital para sa iyong mga business, so pwede mo gamito, no, and then hire ka sa mga skilled and ability with ability worker, no, so para ma-operate. So then raising capital can be difficult. So syempre wala ka partnership mo, wala yung mga capital sa ibo, ang ano mo lang, ang salig mo lang kinadra is pangita ka sa mga sponsors mo dra o mga kilala mo nga pwede magkapital sa iyo mo, or pwede man sa suptan pero lugay pa. Okay, so you cannot run alone with your business, ikaw lang isa mapadalagan. Hindi ka na maging successful, dapat it's about teamwork. Man, teamwork, that's why every time nga may ara ko sang nga i-manage nga section, no, may i-manage nga section, may ara ka mo sa groupings, because this is a training ground. Okay, training ground how you are able to manage your group, your team. Paano mo gamiton ang kaalam sang isa, kung ikaw ang leader, kabalo ka gali nga alam ning upod mo sa amo ning field, so gamiton mo ng alam niya. Okay, for example, sa documentation. So let him or her write a documentation. Okay, in terms of for area namin naman niya statistics, namin sa math, sa calculation. So gamitin mo naman yung alam niya kung ikaw ang leader. So karon, ikaw ang leader naman niya, even though nga wala kaya sa skill niya pareho sa ila, at least kabalo kaya mag-manage. So that's what they call leveraging. Okay, leverage na. You know how to use the skill of others. Okay, ikaw magiging presidente, president ng Pilipinas, or Republic of the Philippines. Now, even though hindi ka man alam, for example, no? What if lang? Nagpadalagan si Pacquiao kag siya ang nagdaog sa pagka presidente, for example lang. Okay, did you agree nga ang tanan nga alam ara kay Pacquiao? Wala. Okay? So hindi naton mambal kay nga may ang aton nga ano government offices has, for example, DOLE, DTI, DPWH, DOTR, ano pa ginada, DENR, okay, TESDA, DepEd, and so on, support lamo kita nga mga ano nga mga offices. So karon, kung dapat, kung ikaw balang presidente, dapat mo gid mabalan, syempre dapat mabalan na. Pero for example, si Pacquiao, no? Magdaog. Kung i-question nyo, bimbalaan ay hantanan ni Pacquiao na ang mga foreign policy and everything. So, we can also surely say na hindi agad na babalaan tanan. Ano brahon niya kung for example siya maging presidente? What if lang? Brahon niya, mang-hire siya sa mga skilled ed with ability worker dira. Sinong alam dira sa DNR? Sinong alam sa DepEd? Okay? Ubrahon niya diyon nga secretary. Kaya ang secretary nga na, siya na bahala na sa mga sa iyang department, which is, example, sa ano legal department and so on and so forth. So, leveraging. Okay? You know how to use the ability of your companion. So, next, the business ends at the owner's death. Okay? Or loss of interest in the business. Okay? Example, kung ikaw ang owner, kag wala kaya sang ang ginatawag na nilang beneficiary, Okay, wala ka sang partnership sa iban. So, the interest of the business, okay, will lost. Okay? Makumadula na ang owner. So, the liquidity of the owner's investment is low. Siyempre, ikaw lang manage, ikaw lang isa. No? So, medyo abadlay na. Kaya mo lang sa mga disadvantages. Again, so let's proceed to the partnership. If two or more people start a business, they must organize as a partnership corporation or limited liability company. So, general partnership, a general partnership is a form of business organization in which two or more people pool their skills, abilities, and resources. It's nice, no? Because it pool their skills, abilities, and resources to run a business. So, meaning, ikaw, for example, nag-ano ka mo? Nag-partnership ka mo? Ano ba lagi mo skill dira? Ikaw nga company ka. Ikaw nga business, ano yung mo abilidad dira? Ano pwede mo mabulig dira sa amon? Okay? Inso in so for. Nan. So, bitiling on, until such time, you can build a business with a strong foundation because there is no company that you can own everything. Okay? You can own everything or you can own everything nga skilled sa imong company. So, you need to have a what you call partnerships. Okay? Because you cannot find, okay, inside everything inside your business. You can find even in outside of your business, okay, para maging successful lang yung mga business. So hindi amo na gani, hindi na siya magiging successful or profitable once amo na siyang mga gin sa sole proprietorship na ikaw lang isa. Nan, ari siya mga disadvantages nyo. So the one of it is liquidity of the owner's investment is low, di ba? So that's why advantage to have a what we call partnership than or a proprietorship. So let's proceed, no? In which two or more people pool their skills, abilities, and resources to run a business. The primary advantage of general partnership over a sole proprietorship is that the business isn't dependent on a single person for its survival and success. So, the term survival is very significant, okay, to start a business. So, hindi lang na pirmi income, okay? There are expenses nga kailan mo nga ano, there are what you call there are expenses nga hindi kaya nga i-sustain sang kaugalingon lang nga income sang business, okay? Hindi na. So kahanan mo nga makipag-partnership sa iban, okay? For example, ang mga banks, okay? Banks, bangko, okay? Na kung wala sila partnership sa iban nga company, okay? Kaysa unang ano, for example, B Metro Bank, there is a partnership in Pinmay UI or in Pinmay Education. So kung sa diin, dira na dagasulod ang amon nga kwarta, sweldo na amon bla, okay? As a faculty in UI, dira na dagasulod. So kung mag withdraw kami kwarta, dira gasulod sa may Metro Bank, kag dira na amon i-withdraw, okay? So subong kay wala na sang ano agreement ang Metro Bank kag UI. So subong nasa China Bank na kami. That's why makita nyo dahil sa mga ano, mga banks nga pwede kung sa din pwede kamo makabayad. So included ang what we call ang China Bank. So sa China Bank na kami gakwa suldo, okay? It's no longer na sa Metro Bank, okay? So kailan pa ni Metro Bank nga makipag partner sa UI, because kung may nagasulod yung kwarta, okay, way kayo makabalo kung magpasulod yung kwarta sa bangko, may saka na. So karon kung hindi mo magtandogo ng kwarta mo within 1 month, So, dako na lang sa ka, 'di ba? 1 month mo ang 100k mo, babe, for example, babe. I-monta na lang 100k. Ang 100,000 nga na. So, amo na siyang pinaka minimum being wala gin kuha sang empleyado sang UI nga sweldo. So, if within 1 month, okay, may saka na. Within 1 month, mapaulam ka lang gani isang kwarta, di ba? Isa ka libo o sa mga gapautang, pila ka percent ang saka, 10%, di ba? Sa mga ano, mga gapautang gid, 5 to 10%. So kung 100,000, pila ang 5 to 10% na? So 5,000 to 10,000, di ba? So amo na sang saka, so may income. Okay, so at the end of the day, partnership ends with income. So kailan lang niya pang income and to survive the business. Okay? So you cannot if you build a business, you cannot afford, okay, to survive your business alone. Okay, yan lang mo makipag-partnership. So advantages of the general partnership, creating one is relatively easy and inexpensive compared to a corporation or limited liability. So mula nang yung advantages sa corporation, relatively easy and inexpensive. The skills and abilities of more than one individual are available to the firm. Diba? Skills and abilities of more than one individual are available in the firm. So, you can find, okay, mga skilled worker, hindi lang isa, kundi damo. Having more than one owner may make it easier to raise funds na. Di ba? So because ang matabo dira, ang business, one business have its own follower or mga suki yung natawag. And ang iba naman dira, ang isa naman ka business has its own followers or mga suki niya. So, pwede siya ka, ano? Pwede siya ka resampans dira. Oh, so, mga sponsors and everything, no? So, business losses can be deducted against the partner's other sources of income. So, it is not subject to double taxation. That will be explained later. Okay. So, for the advantages of the general partnership, liability on the part of each general partner is unlimited. Unlimited. So mula na. Kailan mo gid yon? Actually mag-build ka sa business, kailan may ara gid man liability nga gangot dira. Okay? Magmigahay lang gani, di ba? Relasyon. Relasyon. Ha. May liability dira. So, the business relies on the skills and abilities of a fixed number of partners. Of course, similar to a sole proprietorship and partnership, the partners can be hire employees who have additional skills and abilities. Raising a capital can be difficult. Well, of course, it's a partnership alone, per se. So, medyo hindi pa gidako ang ginatawag na hindi pa gidako ang number of ano employees dira. So because decision making among the partners is shared. Oh, shared siya. This agreement can occur. Di ba? May mga kanya-kanya nga mga opinion ang business if there is a what we call decision to be made. Okay? Ang matabo dira may conflicts, okay? So pwede nga mag disagree, okay? As dire sa aton nga ano, partnership split equally or depending on agreement. So may tawag diyan nga agreement, okay? So what if there is an disagreement? Ano matabo? Okay? Ano matabo dira? So depende sa ilang policy nga ginset. So, kontrata nila kung paano nila ginset ang ilang terms and condition, okay, on their business. So, the business ends at the death or withdrawal of one partner. Wow, nag-break na sila. So, unless otherwise stated in the partnership agreement. O, di ba? So, for example, business ka, and then business ito. So, kung patay ang isa ka business or hindi mag-operate ang isa ka business, hindi man maging successful ang bilog na business. So, for example, 1 plus 1 equals 2. So, ang 2 is successful. Hindi magiging successful ang isa ka business kung hindi 1 plus 0. 1 plus 0 is equals 1. So, meaning, it couldn't be. Okay? So, para maging successful, dapat 2 siya. Okay? So, kay Kron, wala nang isa, pilay na. Okay? Wala na siyang may maubra, hindi na ma-fully operate ang business. So, that's why, may ara sang unconditional dire nga mga scenario. Okay? Pero ang assurance dira, there is what we call partnership agreement. May papel. Okay? May papel nga ginano. May papel nga gin pirmahan. Okay? For example, kami employee kami sa UI. Before we start our what we call employment in the business or in the company, may ara kami isang itawag na kontrata. Even though we have permissions to resign, okay, pero may mga ginatawag kita nga ano with in due time, okay. For example, mambal ko bigyan, ah, hindi ma-resign ako bukas, hindi na ko yung magatinatin niya. Oh, pwede na yan. Example, mistro nyo ko siya, bumamba ko, ma-resign ako bukas, hindi na ko maubra sa UI. O, kuhaan ko na lang sweldo ko para sa August. O, pwede na. Hindi na pwede. Okay? So, pasibo lang ha. Okay? Kung pirmahan, agrihan sang HR o human resource. Okay? So, balik kita sa may ano, partnership. So, may tawag kita partnership agreement. Okay? So, kung withdraw, pag hindi magano, magsugot sa ano, pag-withdraw sang kontrata. Okay? Even though ang kontrata is for example B, 3 years pa before may expire. So, kung ikaw yan nag-withdraw kasi tunga-tunga pa lang sang term nyo. So, kung hindi pagsugtan sang isa, di pa daw yun nun gina. Okay? Para sa annulment bla? Annulment, bala nyo annulment? Sang duwa ka mag-asawa? Oh. So, hindi matabo ang annulment kung hindi magpirma ang both parties or both ang babae ug lalaki hindi magpirma sang annulment. So, dapat papirma gid both sila. So, that's why may mga iban single mom pero ang apelyido nila apelyido sang lalaki because diskan nga dugay na sila split or dugay na sila nga nagbulagay kay wala ni laging process ang annulment subot silingon kasal man sila gyapon legal man sila gyapon. Okay, unless otherwise kung ang bahay kagang laki nagpirma nga mag-annul sila kaging process nila sa court nga ma-annul sila and then ang ilang ang marriage contract nila is why na void na void why na so dapat i-process pa na dayon hindi nga mabaka ay hindi na kuya magano ya wala lang kabog palangga si mo ya lain naman ako nasa baon oh. So may mga ginatawag kita marriage contract okay that's why ang pagpakasal hindi lang na mamba nga ah sige pakasal ko na after 1 week after a year na mabulagay ka. So, annulment, mahal na mag-process. Mahal na mag-process. So, sigurado, doon mo na eh. So, may tawag kita marriage contract. Sa, kung Sa mag-asawa, may ginatawag kita marriage contract. Sa business, may ginatawag naman kita nga partnership agreement, okay, or contract. Para nga may assurance ang pag-ubdanay, okay? And then, the next line is the liquidity of each partner's investment is low gyapon. Diba? So, disadvantages of the general partnership is based on the statistics searched by the author of this module. Okay? So, if we proceed to the corporation, a corporation is a separate legal entity organized under the authority of state. Under the authority of state. So, that's why may tawag kitang ay dako na ni saya. Okay. Mga San Miguel Corporation, ang mga Meralco, 'di ba? So, there are some businesses or corporation with under in the authority of the state nga. For example, power, ano gaya na? So may more power. Oh, Iliko, peak Iliko, tapos Iliko 1, Iliko 2. Kasi din kamodera, more power. Now, mambalbik ro ng more power, hindi na kami mag-operate. Hindi na kami mag-operate. Buwas. Hindi na, i-end na. Muna nga business, hindi na kami mag-operate. Is it possible? Yes or no? Anyone? Jirek. Jirek, is it possible na if the more power decides to stop the operation tomorrow, is it possible? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Pwede, sir.
Pwede siya mag-decide? Buwas way na kurente, no?
Like if, like, ano, sir, like emergency maintenance or something.
Hindi,
sir.
Na-stop na gito siya?
Na-stop na gito. Hindi, oh. Sir, hindi pwede. Kaya wala may mag-provide kurente sa atun.
So, bitilingon, ano ginambal dire? Corporation is? Ano, direct?
A corporation is a legal entity that is the eye of the law. A corporation is a separate legal entity organized under the authority of the of the state.
Nan. Nawasa. Sino ginawasa?
MIWD.
Ha?
Ito dito yung water district.
Mabasa bacon. Hindi na kami mag-provide tubig. Is it public or private? Ang nag-operate. Isang more power. Ang more power, private company or public company na?
Private.
Isa kung private, okay. Ang mga tao, dira hindi, sa, hindi ina, wala ginasulduan sa mga tax. Okay? So, butilingon, under in private income. Kaya, kampanya na. Kampanya. So, kung private na siya, is, even though nga corporation siya, is, may ara pala siya privilege or permission kung the corporation decides to stop tomorrow, the operation tomorrow. So, pwede hindi. Sa manpower, more power, diba, hindi niya. Do, laway naman na boss, way na takulinti yung decide nila yung untot na sila, no? Tapos, ano pa kid? Sa tubig. Diba? Ano pa? In-even ang PLDT. Mag-smart. Unless otherwise, kung yung tato ng ilang renewal, agang operation nila. O, ang mga operators natin sa jeepney operators, like mga Alumpang, ano pa kaya na, Lapas, si Pio, umuntat sila, be? Okay lang na,
Hindi, sir.
Ha? Wala siya ng sakyan? Mga series
saka na? Saka yung ting-ting.
Si Butchilingon, ano ang balis na dito sa statement dito? A corporation is a legal entity that in the eyes of the law. O ginatulok na siya, kumbaga, every operation ni may ginatawag na hindi sila makadecide sa kagalingon lang nila. Okay? So, may ara, sang control, authority, ang state. Okay? Magambala ka state. Okay? Gobyerno. Na, gobyerno. That's why may tawag kita nga separation of the church and state. Na, separation of state and state and church. So dere sa aton oh, sa like for example sa ginpanglawag ko tawagin ng mga companies or corporation. So hindi sila ka decide, okay? Unless otherwise kung sugtan, okay? Sugtan siya sang state o sang gobyerno. Is separate from its owner. Okay? Is separate from its owner. In most cases, the corporation shields its owners who are called shareholders from personal liability for the debts and obligations. So, obligasyon na. Obligasyon niya na tupad dun ang iyang ano. Okay? Ang iyang obligasyon sa iyang serbisyo sa pamuluyo. So, of the corporation. A corporation is governed by a board directors, may mga board directors na, which is elected by the shareholders. So may mga shareholders na or what they call investors. A shareholder is an individual or institution that legally owns a part or more shares. So that's why ang corporation, ABS-CBN Corporation, so may mga investors dira. Okay, that's why may mga issues sila ligad nga nagkakuha mas lagi hapon sang investors nila even though nga wala ni sila sang chang channel. So and then franchise. So nagka-issue din sila. Owns a part of more shares of the share capital of a public or private corporation. For example, Bill Gates, former CEO of Microsoft, has a share in Apple Inc. Wow. May aram sa gali share in Apple. Kumbaga nag-investment sa gali. Oh, 'di ba? So pwede na unless otherwise okay man na ya sa imong kampanya. So in most instances, the board hires officers to oversee the day-to-day management of the organization. It is usually easier for a corporation to raise investment capital than a sole proprietorship or partnership. Diba? So because of the what we call shareholders nga nagatagsang isang individual or institution that legally owns a part or more shares nan of the share capital. So may nagano sila ya, may mga sponsors dira. Okay. Para ma-operate ang ano, mag-operate ang ano. The more income or the more capital sang isa ka business, the more profit, 'di ba? For example, magano lang magtanom ko lang sa plant versus zombies. Kung isa lang kabilog ang plant mo, isa lang kabilog ang imo bro, ang imo kitaon. Pero kung sa imo nga garden, puno na ya sang ano, puno na ya sang tawag na ganya, sang tanom. Every pila ka seconds daan may ga ano nga kwarta sa plant versus zombies, diba? So meaning ang ano ang prinsipyo dira. Okay? The more you plant, so the more you will earn. Okay? Kung may tinanim ka, may aanihin ka, pero kung wala kang tinanim, wala kang aanihin. So the more asset, the more income you will get. So that's why so nag-accept ang corporation sa mga shareholders or individual or institution that legally owns a part or more shares of the share capital. So amo na siya ang ano ang aton nga member dira. Okay? So, that's why, Mayo, kaya nga, dako ang capital. So, like, yung example ko last time sa inyo, bago gani, pila ka percentage ang account nyo ginatag sa capital ni Jerek kag ni Alex. So, 80% no? Tapos, pila lang ka percentage ang ina. Dako ang account makuha. So, the more nga, yeah, dako ang imo capital, dako yung money mo nga kwaon. So, may mga computation man dira. Okay? Nga pwede ibasihan sang shares. So, because the shareholders are not liable beyond their investment in the firm, it is also easier to allocate partial ownership interest in a corporation through the distribution of stock. So, may haras ang partial ownership, okay, sang interest in the corporation through the distribution of stock. Ah. So, establishing a corporation is more complicated than a sole proprietorship. Nga complicated, okay? Komplikado ni kayo, siyempre, the more you gain, the more you gain, the more problems you will get. Okay? For example, blah, damo-damo kamiga, damo-damo kamiga, is it easy or complicated? Komplikado eh, siyempre. May mga kanya-kanya na interest ang miga mo. So, ano naging kanta? Ang isang linggong pag-ibig, Lunes, ano, hasta sa Sabado, hanggang Linggo, nang pag-ibig na, lain-lain. Lunes, lain ang ginupdan mo. Tuesday, lain man. Wednesday, lain man. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, hasta sa Domingo. So, butilingon, kung damo, migamo, kaglain-lain na sa mga interest nila, komplikado na. Same with corporation, okay, more complicated niya because the more damo niya, ano mo, damo niya siya owner, dari, damo niya company, dari, damo-damo na yung mga interest, dari. So, butilingon, komplikado niya siya with compare sa sole proprietorship. Nga, sole proprietorship, ikaw lang na dayang may ano, personal nga decision nga dapat matabo. Unlike ya sa may ano, corporation, may mga board members dira. Okay? Nga lain-lain ang opinion para maging successful ang isa ka business. So, a corporation is formed by filing articles of incorporation with the Secretary of the State, Secretary of State's Office in the State of Corporation. The articles of incorporation typically include the corporation's name, purpose, authorized number of stock shares, classes of stock, and other condition of operation. So, for the advantages of the corporation, owners are liable only for the debts, okay, and obligation of the corporation up to the amount of their investment. The mechanics of raising capital is easier. So, damo tao sa business, so that's why hapus. No restriction exists on the number of shareholders. Stock is liquid if traded on a major stock exchange. The ability to share stock with employees through stock option or other incentive plans can be powerful form of employees motivation. So for the disadvantages of a corporation, setting up maintenance once one is more difficult. Budlay maintenance. Dako ang business, it's more difficult to maintenance. So more difficult than for a sole proprietorship or partnership. Business losses cannot be deducted against the shareholder other income. Income is subject to double taxation, meaning that it is taxed at the corporate and the shareholder levels. Small shareholders typically have little voice in the management of the firm. Siyempre, gamay lang yung mga ginano mo, ginatag, so gamay man yung mga boys. Okay? So, may mga ginatawag na nga kung dako imo investment, dako man imo tingog. Kung gamay investment mo, gamay man imo tingog. What do I mean by tingog or voice? So kung ano magiging decision bala, okay? Ano yung bal mo, ano yung struck mo, ano ang imong opinion sa business. So gamay lang ang consideration dula. Same. So pwede another one, limited liability company. Ano naman siya? Okay, is a popular choice for startup firms as with partnership and corporation. The profits of an LLC flow through the tax returns of the owners and are not subject to double taxation. The main advantage of the LLC is that all partners enjoy limited liability. The LLC combines the limited liability and advantage of the corporation with the tax advantages of the partnership. So for the advantage of the limited liability, members are liable for the debts and obligation of the business up to the amount of their investment. The number of shareholders is unlimited. An LLC can elect to be taxed as a sole proprietor, partnership, pub corporation, S corporation, or corporation, providing a great deal of flexibility. Because profits are taxed only at the shareholder levels, there is no double taxation. So for the advantage of the limited liability company, setting up and maintaining one is more difficult and expensive. Tax accounting can be complicated. Some of the regulations governing LLC vary by state. Because LLC are relatively new type of business entity, there is not as much legal precedent available for owners to anticipate how legal disputes might affect their businesses. Some states levy a franchise tax on LLCs, which is essentially a fee the LLC pays the state for the benefit of limited liability. So for the double taxation, in double taxation is a corporation tax on its net income, and when the same income is distributed to shareholders in the form of the dividends, is taxed again on the shareholders' personal income tax returns. This complication is one of the reasons that entrepreneurial firms often retain their earnings rather than paying the dividends to their shareholders. So before we go through in our module number or activity number 3, skill building activities, please watch this one.
Grammarly is your personal writing assistant for clear emails, confident messages, stronger essays.
Hello, thank you for tuning in. In this video, let's talk about
Hello. Welcome back to the Accounting Heist Lecture Series. My name is Ron and I'm a certified public accountant, but you can call me your professor. In this episode, we're going to talk about the types of business structures or types of business organizations before we go deeper into the other phases of the accounting cycle. By the way, if you missed our first two episodes, we put the link to those videos in the description below. At the end of this video, Dude Papichong, you will be able to describe the types of business organizations, know what makes them peculiar, and be equipped with the basic descriptions and differentiate them from each other. But before we begin, I would like to say a few words of appreciation para sa inyo guys for tuning into our channel and trusting us. We have reached the 100 subscribers threshold, and for some, that number may not seem much, but to us personally, the way we look at it is, wow, we get to help more than 100 students and they are learning, and on top of that, most of them are enjoying. And that, my friends, mga Dude Papichong, is a wonderful feeling. Also, I would just like to make a few shoutouts to the following subscribers na hindi na natin papangalanan, but kilala mo na to kapag nakita mo to. Thank you so much. Lastly, thanks to all the beautiful people who responded to our mini quizzes that they enjoyed the lessons. To those naman who said that they didn't enjoy it, thank you din, no? Rest assured, in every video, we will try to improve and get better. Shoutout lang din to my former students, the awesome, handsome, and beautiful people BSA3, BSA MA3, and BSA MA4 Batch 2018. Thanks for the support, guys. You know who you are. Thank you everyone, and I hope madami pa tayong pagsamahang virtual lessons to come. Again, my name is Ron, Certified Public Accountant, and this is Accounting Heist Episode 3. As I have mentioned earlier, in this video, we're going to talk about the four types of business structures, namely the sole proprietorship, partnership, corporation, and a limited liability company. What is a sole proprietorship? Ang sole proprietorship ang pinakasimpleng business form. Bakit? Because it is owned by a single person. Ibig sabihin, ikaw lang mag-isa as a negosyante or proprietor na nagpapatakbo ng negosyo. Anong implication nun? Sa accounting books, meron lamang iisang owner's equity account at ang profit or loss ay purely sa'yo lang as a proprietor. However, in the eyes of the law, you and your business are considered as one. Ano namang ibig sabihin nun? Ibig sabihin, ang utang ng negosyo mo ay utang mo din. Kapag nadusta ang assets ng negosyo mo, your creditors o mga pinagkakautangan mo ay may habol up to your personal asset. In the income of your business will be treated as part of your taxable income. Because the sole proprietorship is not considered as a separate legal entity. However, Dude Papichong, it shall not be confused with the entity concept of accounting. Hiwalay pa rin ang books ng sole proprietorship. For instance, if you have several businesses like meron kang gym na tinabihan mo ng karinderya sa gilid, syempre diba pagpagod masarap lumamon. Tapos, tabihan mo ng spa para diretso masahin na. Nasa'yo din yon, no? Magkakahiwalay ang accounting books ng gym, karinderya at spa at personal accounting books mo if meron pang other source of income. Pero, all of them are considered as extension of your personality, meaning ang utang ng mga negosyo mo ay utang mo rin. The next form of business organization is the saddest form among the four dahil dito madaming nagtatagpo ngunit hindi itinadhana. Kidding aside, the next one is called a partnership. Ano naman ang tinatawag na partnership? Under a basic scenario, kung kayo ng kaibigan or best friend mo ay nagkasundong magtayo ng business, you are forming in effect a legal contract called partnership. According to Article 1767 of the Civil Code of the Philippines, a partnership is a contract between two or more persons who bind themselves to contribute money, property, or industry to a common fund with the intention of dividing the profits among themselves. Sa madaling salita, Dude Papichong, ito ay isang pagsasama ng dalawang individual sa layuning magkaroon ng bunga ang kanilang pagsasama. Ha, okay? Parang nakakatawa, di ba? Pero yun ang sinasabi ng batas, Dude Papichong. Ang bunga na tinutukoy natin dito ay syempre profit. Wala nang iba, Dude Papichong, ha? For your information din, the law treats the partnership as a separate legal entity. Meaning, kung ikaw at ang quote-unquote kaibigan mo ay bumuo ng partnership, meron tayong third entity na mabubuo bukod sa inyong magkaibigan. Ito yung partnership as a separate legal entity, meaning ang income, assets, liability ng partnership ay pertaining to the partnership in its own right and existence. Kung ikaw ay treated as an individual being a natural person, the partnership is also an individual but it is a juridical person through fiction of the law. Pero although the partnership exists as a separate legal entity, the law holds the general partners personally liable to the liabilities of the partnership. Meaning, just like in a sole proprietorship, the liability of the partnership can extend up to their personal assets. In terms of accounting naman, the difference from a sole proprietorship is that a partnership has more than one equity account. This is because there is one equity account for each of the partners. Also, what makes this one difficult is the computation of profit or loss of each of the partners, but more on that in a separate discussion. The third one is a corporation. Ano naman ang tinatawag nating corporation? In Section 2 of the Corporation Code of the Philippines, a corporation is defined as an artificial being created by operation of law having the right of succession and the powers, attributes, and properties expressly authorized by law or incident to its existence. Medyo komplikado ba, kapatid? Don't you worry, let's break down the definition. Una, kapatid, ang sabi, a corporation is an artificial being created by operation of law. Ibig sabihin nito, kapatid, ang isang korporasyon ay treated by the law as a separate legal entity. Meaning, it is a separate being living through the fiction of law. It has its own rights and obligations separate and apart from its owners. Next, ang sabi, it has the right of succession and the powers, attributes, and properties expressly authorized by law or incident to its existence. Ang ibig sabihin lang nito, kapatid, ang isang korporasyon ay may mga sariling karapatan at kapangyarihan coming from either specific provisions of the law or impliedly given as a result of it being a separate legal entity. Accordingly, unlike a partnership and sole proprietorship, the liabilities of a corporation do not extend to the personal properties of its shareholders. If you want to know more about the powers of the corporation, isearch mo lang Section 36 of the Corporation Code of the Philippines. Legal powers to, kapatid, ha? Walang hit at x-ray vision. From the accounting standpoint naman, the difference from the other forms of business organization is that the ownership in a corporation is divided through stock ownership. Ano ba yung stocks na tinatawag? A stock represents a percentage of ownership in a corporation and is evidenced by a stock certificate. Meaning, kapag hawak mo itong papel na to, kapatid, pwede mong ibalandra sa plaza at ipagmalaking isa ka sa mga corporate owner. Rich kid, diba? The equity of a corporation is composed of three parts, namely share capital, share premium, and the retained earnings. Another major difference is that the net income or loss of a corporation is transferred to the retained earnings account, hindi directly to the share capital. However, this will be discussed further under accounting for corporations. The last type of business organization is a hybrid of the features of a corporation and a partnership. Itong business structure na to, Dud Parichong, ay hindi nag-e-exist sa Pilipinas. So malamang nasa isip mo ngayon kung bakit ko sinasayang ang oras mo sa pagdi-discuss nito. Well, baka sakali lang naman may plano kang magtrabaho overseas pagka-graduate mo. At least, ngayon pa lang, e-aware ka na na meron palang tinatawag na limited liability company. So ano ba tong limited liability company or in short, LLC? A limited liability company is a business structure in the United States kung saan ang mga business owners na tinatawag na members ay hindi liable sa mga pagkakautang ng kumpanya up to their personal assets. Meaning, kapag kulang ang assets ng kumpanya para sa pambayad ng mga utang nito, ang mga pinagkakautangan ay walang habol sa personal na mga assets ng members. Kung mapapansin mo, in that regard, it is similar to a corporation. At the same time, it is similar to a partnership in the sense na you and your friend can form a structure that resembles a partnership, but do away with the unlimited liability that a partnership will give you. If ever naman, medyo advanced reader ka at alam mo na yung tinatawag na limited partnership at baka naku-confuse ka kung pareho lang ba ang limited liability company at limited partnership. Well, Dud Parichong, magkaiba sila. Uulitin ko ha, magkaiba sila. A partnership, although considered as a separate legal entity, binds the partners up to their personal assets. On the other hand, a limited liability company is more like a corporation in terms of the extent of the liabilities of its owners. In addition, the laws governing partnerships and limited liability companies are different, meaning magkaiba sila ng rights, powers, organization requirements, rules to comply with, etc. Sa ngayon, binigyan lang muna kita ng overview kung ano-ano ba ang types of business organization na ma-encounter mo sa accounting. As you go along in your studies, mas makikilala mo pa ng lubusan ang mga business structures na to, especially sa iyong mga business law subjects. Before we end, let's just summarize the key points. There are four types of business structures, namely sole proprietorship, partnership, corporation, and limited liability company. In terms of the extent of liability, the owners are liable up to their personal assets under sole proprietorship and partnership only. Upon formation of a partnership, corporation, and limited liability company, a new juridical person is formed, meaning a separate legal entity. For sole proprietorship, there is only one owner's equity account. For corporations, the equity account is composed of the share capital, share premium, and retained earnings. For partnership and limited liability company, there are as many owner's equity accounts as the number of partners or members. And that ends the discussion for this video. Please don't forget to hit the like button and share this video.
Today, ang pag-uusapan natin is double taxation. Ano nga ba ang double taxation? Ito yung pag nagtatax ka sa dalawang location. Kunwari, sa Pilipinas at sa Amerika. Sa Pilipinas at sa China. Kapag merong agreement ang isang bansa, na doon masasabi kung sino ang magtatax at paano. Punta ka dito sa may double taxation BIR. Click mo to. Hanapin mo yung bansa na gusto mong malaman. Control F. Click mo to. Malalaman mo kung kailan siya ginawa at kung ano yung pinag-usapan dito. Tandaan, itong mga nandito is guide lang gaano kalaki yung babayaran. Pero, ang implementation nito ay nasa may department pa rin na nag-handle ito. So, madami ng kaso na diniskas sa korte kung paano dapat natatax. Magkakaiba yan, depende kung anong type ng entity. Siyempre, may mga iba na bago lang, kung wari ang one-person corporation, hindi pa nakalagay dito. Dahil nung time na ginawa to ay sinauna pa. Kita nyo naman dito. Kung gusto nyo malaman kung magkano ang dapat nyong bayaran sa may buwis, kapag nagtatrabaho ka sa may dalawang lugar, magandang tingnan tong dokumento na to. Kung nakatulong sa'yo to, consider subscribe.
Alright. Okay, so that's our four types of business, form of business. We have sole proprietorship, partnership, corporation, and LLC. Then for the double taxation, okay, you can visit or review this video recording. So to check kung in your corporation, kung may kinatawag na double taxation, so you can check the details on the BIR nga ginpakita sa video. So in our module, so let's proceed no. Dito. Alright, this one. So let's proceed for the activity 3, skill building. Activity, explain why double taxation is big disadvantage and how does LLC avoid double taxation? So anyone can answer kung ano inyong insight dira. Answer ka mo? Alright, this one.
D. Explain why double taxation is a big disadvantage, and how does LLC avoid double taxation? Double taxation is when the company, corporate is taxed and the same time the shareholders are taxed. This is around double the expenses in tax, or double the loss due to tax. In LLC, the shareholders are the only ones taxed, meaning the corporate is free of tax.
And how about this one? Compare sole proprietorship from general partnership. What are their similarities and differences? Ano siyang inyong question dira? Okay. This is your what we call model answer for the question. Okay, so please hear this one.
Explain why double taxation is a big disadvantage, and how does LLC avoid double taxation? Point 2. Sole proprietorship. There is only one owner, and a spouse can be a co-owner. Partnership, in the other hand, has a part in the business, depending on the agreed ownership. Both are single taxed, their businesses' losses can be deducted from the owners, both has difficulties raising capitals, and both are dependent on the skills of the owners. But in partnership it is guaranteed to have more skills because there is more than one owner.
Alright. Okay, question. Anyone from any group present on this Google Meet? Identify. You and your friend do not agree often, so you should avoid this business form. What kind of business form is this? You and your friend do not agree often, so you should avoid this business form. What kind of business form is this? Anyone? Nabaligan talang ang answer? Hello? Mic test. Test mic 1, 2, 3. What kind of business are you? You and your friend do not agree often, so you should avoid this business form. An answer? Why ka mga sabat? Kamu gini karon man, sir. Why hindi ko na mag-share sa inyo? Jerek! Jerek. Hello. Don't tell me to log ka mo. Jerek. Libre ko. Hello, Brico. Test mic. 1, 2, 3. Wala sila kasi, Batman. We couldn't proceed if you will not answer my question. This answer, you and your friend do not agree often, so you should avoid this business firm. So what are those business firm? Is it sole proprietorship, amunibala, partnership, corporation, or limited liability company? Answer. Are you still with me?
Partnership, sir.
Sino to yung answer? So, partnership to. So, thank you so much sa man nag-answer. So, it's the best answer because a lot of disagreement is bad for partnership and must be avoided. So, that's why. So, it's directly with your friend. Okay? You and your friend. So, it's partnership. So, you should avoid this. Okay? Kung if you want to build, lalo na kung magmiguhay ka mo, at tapos hindi ka mo magkasundo sa mga bagay-bagay, so, better not to build the business. Okay? So, once upon a time, there is a, what they call, business assembly. So, one of the rich man or businessman answered from the question of how did your business become successful, and he answered, you know, what he answered in the question. So the question, his answer is, he looks for the woman who can be his partner. Okay, so butilingon, nangita isang babae nga maging partner niya, hindi lang sa pag-build sa pamilya, kundi pag-build sa business. So, that's why naging successful businessman siya. Unlike, for example, B, partner mo, tatanan mo nga desisyon sa kabuhi mo, disagree siya. So, paano ka muna maging successful? Lalo na sa pamilya mo or pagtindog sa business. So, better not to build the business kung amo na siyang sitwasyon niyo subong. Okay? So, pangita ka sang tao nga mayara ka amo sang common nga opinion. Okay? Kag pananaw sa kabuhi, kag sang negosyo. Dira, magiging successful ka mo. So, that's partnership. So, thank you so much. So, for the second question, you and your friend already have a lot of cash for a business. May kwarta, may capital, and you already have expenses in businesses, but you do not want your business to be taxed too much. What business form should you take? Hindi sa kuno gusto nga mag-tax bra, mag-attack tax too much. Ano na siya nga klase form of business? So, may kwarta ka mo. Okay? So, this one, you and your friends already have a lot of cash for a business. Meron ang cash. And then, so, this one, have experience in business, but you do not want your business to be taxed too much. So, bichiling on, may business na. So, what kind of business is that? You and your friends. So, is
corporation,
it,
sir.
You and your friends. Huh?
Corporation. Sala.
Lower than that. So, it is?
LLC, sir.
LLC and or partnership. Okay. So, LLC or partnership. So, limited liability corporation or partnership. So, naka-backslash siya. So, pwede sa ma-consider as a partnership, and then siyempre kung partnership ka, gamay lang yung magiging tax mo, no? Siyempre gamay man lang darang obligasyon mo. Unlike kung nasa corporation ka, so when it comes to the tax payment of the tax, LLC is better, okay, to build than corporation. So para ma, kumbaga magiging tawag niya silang ano, tax avoidance nila, tax avoidance. Do you know what is tax avoidance? Do you have an idea about that one?
Avoid tax.
Ha?
Avoid tax, sir.
Avoid tax, pero do you know what's the hidden agenda, the hidden part of that? Ba mo, may mga businesses nga, ara na mo. So, ara na. Okay, napatindog na. But they look a way to avoid tax. Meron na. So that's why banyo mamba ko lang sa bamo nagatan ako sa mga hearings, mga for example sa House of Representatives, sa Senate hearing. So ginbantayan jugid nang iya kay EBCBN. Isa ka issue sang EBCBN is what they call tax avoidance. Oh. Paano bala sila nakakuha sa tax avoidance? Ariyo, let's check this out. Ariyo, para may idea lang kamo.
Para... What is the difference between tax evasion and tax... I'm going to tell you, what is the difference between tax evasion and tax avoidance? I'm going to tell you in this video. Hi, I'm Andrew Henderson. This is one of the questions that people ask when they first start consuming our content at Nomad Capitalist is he talking about tax evasion or is he talking about tax avoidance? What's the difference? Well, in simplest terms, the difference is one is legal and one is illegal. Tax evasion is illegal. This is where you evade your legal responsibilities to pay tax. And if you go back and look at history, so many of the mobsters have been convicted on tax evasion. The government sat around and figured, we can't get them on any of this other stuff, but let's just go in because we know they're making money and they're not reporting it on their income tax. Now, what were the mobsters doing? The mobsters were sitting in the United States. They were running United States businesses. They had all their employees in the United States. Everything they were doing was in the United States. And you can move this to Canada, Australia, the UK, or any other country you want. Okay? In anywhere that you live, there is going to be a tax code. Here are the rules of what you need to pay. Now, in some countries, there are no taxes. In some countries, they only tax money that you earn within their country. Anything you earn somewhere else, they leave it alone. And so that creates a lot of opportunities to pay very little tax. We'll get into that in a moment. But tax evasion is something that is illegal. You're required to pay the tax, and you don't. Here's what's interesting about this. Tax avoidance is legal. It's where you figure out, what can I change to make it so that I can legally pay less or even zero tax? It's all legal. What's funny is that people come and they look at what we talk about offshore.
Oh, all right. Masalot, ma-interject lang ko. So, in terms, you know, in the issue of ABCBN and GMA, so the issue of the Congress from the ABCBN, the GMA paid 1 billion of taxes during the range of years, no? But the ABCBN only paid 100 almost or more or less 100 million, okay, of tax na kinbayaran nila, same with the years duration, okay, in GMA. So natabo dira, how come does the ABCBN only paid more or less 100 million, while the GMA paid 1 billion of pesos. So how come? Okay, ano ang ilang mga practices na nakaano sila ya? Nga 100 million lang yan, like yes, GMA yan, nag 1 billion na to. So those are the ano questions of the Congress in ABS-CBN. Okay, that's why the ABS-CBN wasn't renewed. Okay, approved the renewal sang ilang franchise sa ilang business.
Oh. Amo na sir ang may mga product sila nga TV Plus, amo nang ga tax evasion, ano sila ga tax avoid.
So mga... there are so many practices nga gin-apply dira ang ABS. So we cannot go into deeper sina kay because damo sila da mga ano mo mga practices nga ginaano in detail nga confidential nga ang Congress lang makakita. Pero isa na siya ka issue ang ilang ano ang box niya na. No, isa na ka issue actually ang box nga gin-offer nila last time ay kontra na siya sa ano eh cable company ang ano ang box nga ginatag nila. So kontra sa cable company. So that's why ginkontra pagid sila sang cable company like Sky, ano pagid ng mga cable company ginkontra sila.
The partner na sila sang Sky wala sir mo?
Oh, partner sang Sky pero iban pagid lang ang company nga hindi lang Sky.
Signal.
No? So amo na sa ginkontra na sila sang iban nga sang cable company because sang box nga na. Pero hindi lang amo nang issue nila. So lang tawon tabi proceed to ni. Okay? Para ma banyo when you build a business may mga ginatawag itang liabilities. Okay? Bitsilingon, liable ka to comply with. Okay? So kung hindi mo complyan, bala mo may ginatawag kita, 'di ba? May legal entity. So ang partnership, ikaw nga individual is a legal entity. Ano ka? Entity ka. And then your partner is a legal entity. Also, and then when you build a partnership, okay, it would be created another entity, okay, which is ang inyong again build niya partnership, and same with corporation and LLC. So let's listen this or watch this video.
How many people who say tax avoidance is wrong, I don't agree with it morally, how many of those people are going and selling stuff on the side? They have a cash side hustle. They're earning cash under the table somehow, or they're making some kind of money, you know, through a Super Bowl pool at the office, and they don't report that as income. That's technically tax evasion. The United States government and most governments say all income has to be reported. If you earn income, you know, $50 for cleaning your neighbor's house, they pay you in cash, that should go on your tax return. How many people do that? See, I was raised to be really ethical about tax. Remember, I had a summer job when I was in high school. I worked at a restaurant. And generally what happened was, in the restaurant business, you may know this, people pay on a credit card, and the guests tip on a credit card, the waiters will be required to report that tip because the restaurant collects that tip, and then they just give it to the waiter in their paycheck, and so therefore they have to tax it because the restaurant doesn't want to get nailed for tax evasion. But when someone leaves a cash tip, it's generally accepted, or at least it was back then. Oh, you just kind of put that tip in your pocket. Hey, I don't know, they didn't tip me, who knows? I remember my father getting really, really specific with me one day. I was gonna do the carryout. I couldn't be a waiter, so I was going to bring people their co-orders. And he said, I want you to make sure you're keeping track of all your cash tips because you're going to report it on your income tax because that's the right thing to do. I'm not raising a tax evasion.
Knowing the difference between tax evasion and tax avoidance is important because it can mean the difference between paying lower taxes and going to prison. Robert is looking for a way to lower his gross income. And
anyway, if you won't pay your taxes as a business, what will happen to you? to you or with your business, it will go into prison. So, or you will be forced to pay your taxes. So, may mga liabilities dira. So, that's why so, when you build a business, so dapat consistent ang imong service. So, let's proceed.
Reduce the amount of money that he pays to the government in taxes. Robert decides to engage in tax avoidance by maximizing the full amount of tax deductions and tax credits that he can take. Robert maxes out his 401k contribution amount and donates to different charitable organizations so that he has the lowest adjusted gross income possible. Once Robert files his tax liability will be much lower than it would have been if he had not employed this strategy. Subsequently, Robert has a lower tax bill. Robert employs tax avoidance, which is the use of different methods and strategies to lower the amount of taxes that he owes.
Oh, so it's nice, no? Tax avoidance, the use of different methods and strategies to lower the amount of taxes owed. So that's why, muna yung mga practices, isa sa practices niya ginubras ang ABS-CBN. So that's why nakapay sila yung mga more or less 100 million, unlike, while DJ may paid 1 billion. So, muna natin nga, lasang iba nyo, ano. So, that's why, siguro, why lang ko balo kung ano pa kinadang mga conflicts nila sa tax avoidance. I think, more on tax avoidance ang practices ng ABS-CBN. Ano? So, ang agang ila issue sa Congress, no? Ang tax avoidance. So, let's proceed.
This method is perfectly legal and is used by accountants and tax
Even though is it legal, no, legal siya. May mga nakita pagdadaan ano, may mga nakita pagdadaan ang iba niya mga congressman sang illegal nga ginobra nila. Okay? So tanawan niyo lang blang mga ang hearing about sa ano. Sa franchise ng ABS-CBN. So, used by accountants and tax professionals. So, let's see.
Professionals to save their clients money. If Robert would have gone the route of tax evasion, then he would have found himself in hot water. Tax evasion is an illegal practice that involves intentionally avoiding paying taxes that are owed.
Nah. So, is it tax avoidance ang in-practice ng GMA or tax evasion? So, ano ng mga questions nga, why does ABS-CBN wasn't renewed their franchise in Congress? Because the Congress is the only legislator, okay, nga makapasa sa ilang franchise, not the Senate, okay?
Had Robert chosen the tax evasion route, he would not have reported all of his earnings to the Internal Revenue Service.
Oh, and it wasn't reported all the revenue. Tanan niya nga kita, for example, B, dibla, what's the purpose of the receipt? Mga resibo. Nga, kadabakal niyo may mga resibo. Every businesses, sole, partner, corporation LLC man na sa business should what you call produce a receipt, okay, para lang nabala sa inyo, because ano na siya, ang it is a liability or obligation na sang isa ka business nga mag-produce ang resibo, okay? Kaya ang resibo nga na amo na siyang magiging basihan. Okay, magiging base yan sang tax, okay, sang isa ka business. So karon magiging tax evasion na siya kung for example B, ang actual nga kita sang actual nga kita sang imo nga business is ara sa 100,000, okay, yearly. Do ka gamay, no, yearly 100,000. So let's say na lang 100,000 ang kita mo sang isang imo nga business kada tuig gamay.
Sir, ang Changi as liable magatag ano, sir, resibo? curious lang ko.
Ang ano, ang pero may mga exemptions dira. May mga exemptions. So, kung gin pa diti ay mo na siya. Okay? Barangay clearance man lang nadaya ang mga tiangge.
Awas.
Barangay clearance. So, ko pero kung mga DTI under sa DTI, what is DTI? Oh, anong DTI?
Trading and Industry, sir. Department of Trading. Department of Trading and Industry.
Na, trade. Oh, kumagana maka trade. Ah. So are, para nga may idea lang. Ilang. The DTI is responsible for realizing the country's goal of globally competitive and innovative industry and services sectors that contribute to exclusive internet support. And then DTI produced business permits. Okay? Sa mga Seoul Partnership Corporation and the kung dako na ang business mo, okay, like ABS-CBN, gakadtogin na siya sa ano, sa what you call, sa Congress, because the Congress is the one, the only agency can pass the franchise of the ABS-CBN. That's why ang ginobala sa Senate last time nga hearing sa ABS-CBN, useless to siya. Kumbaga public ano lang to, public exposure lang to siya ang ginobra nila. Kaya nag-conduct sila sa hearing mo Senate, even though nga hindi na ila obra. Ang obra ang may obligasyon nga mag-conduct sa hearing is the Congress. But the Senate did it, okay? For public exposure lang. Pero wala sa weight. Kung silingon sang weight, hindi bala maka-apekto kung mapasar o hindi. Kumbaga, ano lang yan, ang simpati lang sa mga tao ang ginubra nila dito. Eh, ginpakita nila sa hearing dito nga the renewal of the ABS-CBN should pass. Okay? Pero, ang ila decision couldn't be affected sa decision sang Congress. Ha. So, kung gindula siya sang Congress, wala nila ginaprubahan. So, hindi na yun magkadto sa may Senate in June Super. Kay sa may ano pa lang, sa Congress pa lang, wala na. So, disapprove na. So, sad to say, daong manta kita idol sa may ABS-CBN, kailan kay amo nang natabo. So, accept na lang ta. So, tana naman, naka-online, pwede ka naman kakapamilya online live, di ba? So, kada adlaw, naka-100,000 man sila nga viewers. So, it's good naman. So, proceed to deal.
And would have ignored disclosing the interest earned on his savings account. Robert would run the risk of facing criminal charges.
Actually, same with ano. Same with sa mga politics niya eh. Mga politician, magpadalaga na sila sa ano, sa posisyon sa gobyerno, magyatawag na sila ng ano, what do we call that term? I-open nila, tanan nilang account, okay, para maging transparent. For example, be ang kita, ang kwarta mo si Bongbi, nagpadalagan ka, no? No? For example, be si Bongbong Marcos, nagpadalagan, sa nag-declare siya, ng kwarta niya is nasa, for example, be, ala, sa 100 million, kwarta niya, nasa 100 million. After be, for example, be 1 year, ang kwarta niya nag 1 billion. Okay? So makita na ang kung ano, makita na nga ang sang nagsulod ka sa politika. Okay? Kwarta mo 100 million. Pero after 1 year, nag 1 billion ang kwarta mo. How come nga nagamuna? Pila mo lang suldo sang ano, for example, be senador. Pila mo lang suldo nila da, more or less, ara sa 300,000. 300,000 times 12, pila? No, 300,000 times 12. sumangara sa 3 million na dira 3 million to 4 million. So 100 million after 1 year 12 months lang manda. Oh, how come na gabing saka sa kwarta ko ba? 100 million tapos nag 1 billion after 1 year. So so that's why sell-in, okay? Sell-in na saglit, tawag sell-in. Para may idea lang, sell-in. Statement of assets, liabilities and net worth. Okay? Statement of asset, liabilities and net worth. So that is sell-in. So before na sila magpadalagan sa posisyon sa gobyerno, ang ilang sell-in gina-declare nila na. So that's why ang iba niya mga politika ginakasuhan sa corruption. That's because of the sell-in. Previously, gin-declare nila sell-in nila 100 million. After 1 year, ang kwarta na nila is nag 1 billion na. How come nga naga muna? So that's why damo ng mga public officials gina-presyo. Na-presyo kay kaya munang natabo nila. Okay? Ay, bandan, hindi honest mag-declare sang sell-in mo. Okay? Wala nila gina-declare tanan. So, in terms of the business, that's why may mga resibo na. Okay? May mga resibo. So, ma'am, balbe karon nga, ang kita sa business ko ni 100 million. Okay? 100,000 yearly. Amuna sa actual. Pero, ang gin-declare mo lang sa may DTI, sa BIR, is ara lang sa 50 mil, 50,000 lang. So, but silingon, okay, that will fall on tax evasion because wala mo gin-declare gid ang insaktong amount. Okay? So, that's why ang iban, kita nyo, pero frankly speaking, kakadto ka mo sa mga gasolinahan. Gasolinahan. So, kung may motor ka, magbagasolina ka, wala ka ginarilisan sang resibo, so, but silingon, kung wala ka ginarilisan sang resibo, ano matabo? Avoid? Okay, tax evasion na. So, but silingon, nagbakal ka, wala ka ginarilisan sang resibo, okay? So, may kaso na sila? May kaso na basta business, dapat marilis na resibo. Okay? Pero kung kisa, okay na lang na. Okay na lang. Ay kung wala resibo, wala accounting, wala liquidation. Okay? Wala liquidation. So, kag hindi mabalaan, hindi ma-determine kung pilagid man ang pagpasulod sa kwarta, kag pagwa sa kwarta. So, ang resibo is very important for liquidation. Okay? Liquidation. So, let's proceed.
And paying substantial fines and penalties. Tax avoidance will allow taxpayers to either lower their tax liabilities altogether or defer them to a much later date. This is a much better option than tax evasion, which will increase the tax liability if discovered and leave the taxpayers subject to fines.
Again, tax avoidance is legal. So, may mga strategies lang na gina-apply dira para magnubo ang ilang tax. Okay? May mga ginobra lang sila ng mga strategies. Unlike sa tax evasion, illegal gina siya because there are some practices na hindi sila honest mag-declare sa mga assets nila. So, ang isa pag gila ka-issue, gilit nila dira, ang duta nila, gin-declare nila, pila lang ka-hectares, no, pila lang ka-hectare dira, ang gin-declare nila, more or less, bro. So, kung wala ko nagsila, mga apat lang ka-hectare, pero in total, dako pag ginadira ang ilang, dako pag ginadira ang ilang asset sa duta. So, ba mo kung may duta, ka may tax ka mo, okay, may duta, may ara ka na duta, may tax na. So, ginabaydan mo na da yun kung pila na da ang declaration sang tax ang iyong mga duta na. Kung lalo na kung commercial area. Okay? So, isa pa ginobras ang EBS is ang gin-declare nila maara lang sa more 4 hectares. Pero sang gin-check sang Congress hindi lang gali 4 hectares ang ila asset ang dot ang lot nila hindi lang dako pa na gidada ang ila asset sa lot. So tax evasion na. Okay? First primarily gineclare nila 4 hectares pero sa gin check hindi lang gali 4 hectares ang ila nga ang ila lot. Okay? So isa na siya sa issues or conflicts nga nakita sa Congress. So ako sa inyo tanaw-tanaw ako mo sang ano sang mga hearing sa Senate sa may House of Representatives. So para mabalaan yung status ng kalibutan sa atong susyudad para maging ano kamo truly a public or Filipino citizen. Si Filipino citizen participates, okay, lalo na sa voting, mag-eleksyon. So, dapat nakakuha na kamo sang or nakapag pa-renew na kamo para nga makaboto kamo sa 2022 nga election. So inyo na obligasyon, so para nga maging ano kamo makuha niyo yung pribileyo later on lalo na sa gobyerno, kay requirement na siya. Okay, hindi ka pwede makakuha sang barangay clearance kung hindi ka voters. So dapat voter ka. Okay, gusto mo magpatindog sang ano sang business sa inyong barangay tapos wala ka nagvote, ano ang balon sang barangay captain? Nagboto ka sang ligat niya eleksyon, wala. O wala. Subot silingon, you will be declined or disapproved sang imong application sa pagpatindog dra sang business sa inyong barangay because hindi ka, wala ka nagboto sang amuna nga eleksyon because that is your obligation and privilege muna nga makakuha ka sang business. Pero as a citizen ken nanuman i-comply ang imo obligasyon na magboto ka man sa darating na eleksyon. So amo na siya. Bawi-bawi lang na. Okay? So right. So let's proceed. Damo no, damo kada balan lalo na kung sa business sectors ka. So number 3, you just want to try opening business. You have the money and you have a backup plan. If every you fail at the business, what business type is recommended for you? Kung ano ko no? If every you fail, every plan is failed at the business, what business type is recommended for you? Ano na siya? Any guest? Kumbaga wala ka pagid assurance bala, kumbaga wala ka pagid sang strong foundation in business. Madretso kayan sa corporation. Wala ka pa sang prior. Wala ka pa prior knowledge. Dibla ano ang balga ni Dres Babaw? So dapat may ara ka sang full control. May ara ka dapat hands-on ka sa imo business before ka mag-build. Dapat ka balo ka na isang pagwa sulod sang kwarta. Ano Dre? Owners maintains complete control over the business. If not, ano matabo? You will fail. Sakto ko? Kung wala ka sample control sa business, ano matabo? You will fail. So what business appropriate for you? It is? Diba?
Tol.
Hindi ka magdetso. Kumbaga, ano na lad? Ladder na mo? Ladder na. Di, labla, may harap kita first year, second year, third year, fourth year. Karon kung college ka pa lang, madretso ka na sa fourth year, ano matabusin mo? Labla, may mga prerequisite kita. Prerequisite? Labla, may programming 1, programming 2. May capstone 1, capstone 2. Pwede ba lang ma-proceed ka sa capstone 2 without taking the capstone 1? Diba? So those are the consideration. Now may mga prerequisites na. Okay? So, ang question is, this one. Kung hindi pa strong ang foundation mo, what business appropriate for you? It is a sole proprietorship because if you are with other people, you are liable to their situations. Liable ka sa sitwasyon nila. So, that's logically stated. Okay? So, number four, you wanted to join a business and it is the first time but you have friends who already have experience in business industry. What form of business do you suggest them? Oh, may aralasang ano, experience in business industry.
Corporation.
And also, or LLC, or, okay, Limited Liability Corporation. So, thank you so much. If you are confident and hardworking, then go for LLC. Corporation are easier to make, especially if you are new. Five, you and your friend are very close. May harap na kamo closure. Yeah, diba? Your skills complement each other. Wow. But you don't have enough capital to start a business. What form of business is recommended?
LLC, sir. LLC kay wala pa sila daan enough nga capital, so may ara gadya risk nga no nga mabayad sila tax. Amo na LLC.
If your source of capital is low but you wish to own a business that you are the boss, even if you have a companion, the recommended is definitely partnership. Oh, partnership. So, Ambaldirio, requirement na niyo sang partnership. Unlike sa Ambaldirio, do not agree of 10. So, do not agree of 10. So, requirement of the partnership, dapat may closure ka mo. And then, may skills each other. Oh, may kanya-kanya ka mga skills. And then, nag-join forces ka mo. Ugali, ang problem lang, but you don't have enough capital to start a business. So, wala pa ka mo capital sa business. So, but silingon, ang inyo lang may hala ka mo, isaryo. Okay? So that's why ang skills na may hala ka mo kag closure nyo. So ang adryo sa may partnership, that's why adryo, skills and abilities, dapat may hala ka mo sa ano, hala siya. Ang ano lang day, ang disadvantage, raising capital. Oh, raising capital can be difficult. So, amo nang problem. Disadvantage lang. Ay, siyempre, duwa mo lang kamo mo. Okay? Mangita ka mo dara ko rin sa mas sponsor sa inyo. Okay? Amo na siyang problem. Te, so, na-pull siya sa partnership. So, disadvantage lang, raising capital. Okay? So, na-pull siya sa partnership. So, for the activity, Dina, what I know, what have you learned? So, please answer. And then, number 5, check for understanding project update, choosing your form of business. So, determine what business form you will be using in your plan. So, that's why last time, in-asta ka mo sang inyong brainstorming, okay, new ventures, and explain why it, if it is partnership, who will be your partner, if it is corporation or LLC who are the members. Meron na ka mo? Note, a sole proprietor can be more than one member. Siyempre, more than one member, may isa ka owner din kumpanyon. Although, only one can make a final decision, kasi siyempre ang owner lang na. In the group, partnership can have up to 5 members. So, partnership, dua lang ang owner, pero may mga companions. But sila yung companions, may mga empleyado, bla, kumbaga. Pero, in voting, decision, ang dua gigitagiya, siyempre, with equal shares and decision power through voting. So, consider this one. Mayara ka mo update? Mayara ka mo update i-share sa bong or sa basic exam ko na yung pamangkoton sa inyo? You need to produce a documentation for this based on modules na yung pang-discuss natin. Do you have now a plan for your business? What form of business do you plan to build? Butilingon, silence means wala pa sang sang decision kid. All right, so I will just send you an instruction for you to answer those questions. Okay, kung ano na siyang ano nyo. Pero sa brainstorming, please repeat or review the brainstorming kung paano mag-conduct sa brainstorming. Okay? That is module number 5, chakto ko. So, please repeat nyo na lang and then that para maka-provide ka mo sa akon nga, ano, sa question. Okay? So, that's the end of the of module number 6. So we'll be proceeding to module number 7. So thank you so much.